Any organization has its own objective, but a part of that, they have some social objective, that is, that is what they contribute for the society. And finally, we can't even overlook the person, the individual who are working over there. So, apart from organization objective, the company, they has some objective towards the individual, the employees, as well as towards the society with organization objective. What do you think? What should be the primary objective of any business? Any guess? Yes, business must be able to sustain itself in a dynamic environment, and company will sustain only when its revenue is enough to cover its cost. So, what is the first objective? The first objective is survival. Now, mere survival is enough. What if, suppose, when the company, they want to hire competent employees, or they want to open some more branches all over the country, then what will happen? Now, only survival is not enough. Any company wants leftover after covering its cost, and that leftover is profit. So now the second point is profit. After survival, then the company wants to earn profit. And why the company wants to earn profit? The company wants to earn profit because now they want to compete with the competitors, to stand in the market, to hire more competitive employees. For that, because to grow in the dynamic environment. So these are the organizational objectives: survival, profit, and growth. Now next is social objective. Every company has societal obligation to fulfill, and they are much beyond directly adding to society. So now we'll see what are those social objectives which the company should fulfill. They are funding to school, providing free healthcare. Then business should also need to protect and preserve the natural environment, provide employment opportunity to the disadvantaged section of the society, and by minimizing pollution by using environment friendly method of production. Social and organizational objective. Let's go to individual now. As each individual is different, as all are from different background, all have different hopes and aspirations. So different people, some people work for financial need, so they want good salary. For some has social need, like they want peer recognition, and some wants to contribute for the society. So this is all for the objectives of a business. Levels of management. Are all managers same? No. They are divided on the basis of nature of work and skill. We'll explore this differences in this segment. Management can be divided into three levels on the basis of their responsibility and nature of problems they deal with. And what are those levels? Those levels are top level, middle level, and lower level. The top level management, it consists of senior most representative of an organization. They are usually referred to as vice president, CEO, president, or chairman also. And you know, students, generally number of managers at this level, that is at the top level, they are very less. And at this level, lots of creative thinking is required. And what are the functions being performed by top level managers? These top level managers, they used to formulate overall organizational goals and strategies. Then they are responsible for the welfare and survival of the organization. They need to analyze business environment, the environment in which the business has to survive. Arrange resources of men, machine, material, and money. So this is the function being performed by the top level managers. Middle level managers, they are actually the link between the top and the lower level managers. Usually they are divisional head or head of departments of different departments. Now they are having these middle level, they have some responsibilities for upper level managers also and lower level managers. Actually they act as a link between these two. On one hand, they are responsible for implementing the plans and strategies planned by the top management, and on the other hand, they are responsible for all the activities of lower level managers. Middle managers has to understand the plans and policies adopted by the top management and then communicate to the managers of lower level. And now we'll see what are the functions of middle level managers. So these are the some of the functions of middle level managers. They are to ensure the department has the necessary personnel, means that each and every department, they do have the persons who actually is going to work. Then to assign necessary duties and responsibilities to them, means which kind of people are required and who has to do what kind of work. Then to motivate them to achieve the desired objectives, as you all know, objectives are pre-planned, and so the function of middle level is to motivate them to achieve the desired objective. Then to cooperate with other department for smooth functioning of the organization. As we all know that in isolation you can't do any work, so you have to cooperate. Being a business person, you have to cooperate with each other, and then only you will be able to achieve the organizational goals. Last level is lower level management, and it is also known as supervisory level or operational level too. They are the first line managers, as they are directly in the contact with the work of managerial employees. Supervisor, foreman, floor manager, they all belongs to the this supervisory level, and this level is responsible for interacting with the actual workforce. Now we'll see the functions of this supervisory level. So what are the functions? The functions are to oversee the efforts of the workforce, means actually work being done by the employees on the ground floor. So this level is responsible to see the efforts being done by the workforce. Then to ensure safe and proper working environment, that the environment in which the worker is working, they are doing the work, it is safe for their worker or not. To interact with actual workforce and pass instructions to the middle management to the workers. Means now in what they used to do, they interact between the actual workforce and between the middle level managers. Then they represent the workers' grievances. Suppose there is any misunderstanding or any kind of grievances between the workers. So this is the duty of the lower level managers to tell or to pass the such kind of grievances to the middle level, so that the middle level must know each and everything of the ground level managers. So these are the functions of the lower level managers. And here we are completing our the different levels of managers and their functions as well.